the dear students, moving forward, remaining in what we have observed in the photoelectric effects. In that photoelectric effect, we have observed certain two points were discussed just regarding the photoelectric effect. Experimental observation we have observed. Now the third point regarding the experimental observation we are discussing right now. Now we'll discuss the kinetic energy of the ejected electron is directly proportional to the frequency of the incident radiation and independent of its intensity. Its meaning, the kinetic energy, that means the electron is moving from one end to another end. Electron is moving from positive, from negative terminal to positive terminal, you know that, inside this glass tube. For this movement, it needs a kinetic energy, and this kinetic energy doesn't depend on the intensity of light. Intensity means brightness of light. So whatsoever the brightness, whether it is weak or strong brightness or moderate brightness, it doesn't make any changes in their kinetic energy. It doesn't contribute towards the kinetic energy. But the frequency of the incident light, incident radiation, contributes towards the kinetic energy. So this is the experimental observation that that kinetic energy of the ejected electron, which is moving from the metal surface towards the receiver, towards the positive terminal where the receiver is there, okay, that identify the electron and takes over the electron and send into the circuit. So how does these electrons are moving from that, from the metal surface towards the positive terminal? This movement requires kinetic energy, and that kinetic energy is provided by the frequency of the incident light, but not the intensity. Whatsoever the brightness, no problem at all. Okay. Now next is the number of electron ejected per second from the metal surface do depends upon the intensity or brightness. Do depends upon intensity or brightness of radiation, but does not depend upon its frequency, number of. If you increase the brightness, that means you are increasing the number of photons. We'll discuss again it, number of photon, and each photon causes to release one electron. So that is when you are increasing the number of, when you are increasing brightness, then you are increasing the intensity. When you are increasing the intensity, then you are increasing the number of photons. If the number of photon is increasing, then the number of electron ejected per second will increase. So amount of current will increase. What is current? Number of electrons passing through a particular point per second. So if the number of electron is increasing per second with the increase in intensity, so that means the number of photoelectron is increasing as well as the current will increase. So your battery or cell will get charged in a very less time. So that is why we say that the number of electron ejected per second from the metal surface do depends upon the intensity or brightness of light. So if you want that number of electrons should increase, then you increase the brightness. As you are increasing the brightness, the number of electrons will increase. But number of electrons you are going to increase once the electrons are ejected. So that means you should have a radiation having a certain minimum amount of frequency. That is called threshold frequency. If you are not having that kind of energy which is having the threshold frequency for a particular metal, then there will be no ejection of electron. When there is no ejection of electron, how can you increase the number of electron? So first criteria that you should have the energy radiation having a threshold frequency at least. More than that, it is more. It will produce more kinetic energy. Okay. So kinetic energy depends upon the frequency. Kinetic energy depends upon the frequency, not depends upon the intensity or brightness of light. But the number of electron ejected do depends upon the intensity of light or brightness of light. So this is the difference. So Maxwell was not able to explain this. Now you can see this graph. This is the graph in which the graph is plotted between the frequency of light and the kinetic energy of ejected electron. This is the kinetic y-axis represents the kinetic energy of ejected electron, and this x-axis represents the frequency of the light. Now you see, this point is the threshold energy. This is the mu naught. This is the threshold energy. That means this much minimum frequency of light is needed to have a ejection of electron. If this value of mu naught at is less than this, then you start here. So this is the minimum frequency is required to eject the electron. So that's why we have started from there. And as the frequency of light is increasing, kinetic energy is also increasing. As the frequency of light is increasing, kinetic energy is also increasing, because you are getting a straight line. Okay, so that means the frequency of light and kinetic energy has got a direct relation. So kinetic energy of ejected electron is directly proportional to the frequency of light. That is why we are getting a straight line graph. Okay, so this graph proves that there is a direct relation. Okay, now the second graph we get, graph is plotted between the intensity of light and kinetic energy of the ejected electron. Now you can see here, as the intensity of light is increasing, there is no change in the kinetic energy of the ejected electron. It remains same. It remains constant. It remains uniform. No change at all. Constant value of kinetic energy. That means whatever electron is coming out of the metal surface, all are having the same kinetic energy. Although you are increasing the intensity of light, that means brightness of light you are increasing, but there is no change in the kinetic energy of the ejected electron. So these two graphs tells you what I taught you, third point. Now I'll give you another example. Take the metal surface of potassium. So potassium will be acting as a negative terminal, and then you put a detector inside a detector, that means receiver, which receives the electron. Okay. Now potassium will release the electron. Now you know that what is the threshold frequency for potassium, that is 5×10⁴ per second. That means this is the minimum amount of frequency is required to eject the electron from the potassium surface. So this is the minimum amount. Now we have carried out the experiment with the two light energy. One is the red light. So this is the frequency for red light. This is the range of frequency of red light, 4.2 to 4.6×10⁴ per second. This is the frequency of red light, the frequency range of red light. And then the frequency of yellow light, you can see here, this is 5.1 to 5.2×10⁴ per second. Here you can see the frequency of red light is lower than the threshold frequency of potassium, 4.3 to 4.6. here it is 5×10⁴, here 4.3 to 4.6×10⁴ per second. So the threshold frequency of potassium is much higher than the frequency of the red lights. So if you pass the red light, if you make the red light be incident over the potassium surface, that it will not eject electron, because their frequency is much lower. Although whatsoever the if you are giving the very strong brightness, that intense red light means very bright red light, even if you pass the very bright red light, it might be even so bright that your eye won't be able to tolerate. That much of brightness, beyond that brightness also you can put, that you are able to tolerate that red light. You are bringing so much brightness. but it will not eject electron. Potassium will not eject electron whatsoever the brightness whatsoever. Increase and increase as what you think, but there will be no ejection of electron when you pass the red light over the potassium, because the frequency of red light is much lower than the threshold frequency of potassium. So that's why there will be no ejection of light. That means a red light will not give you the photoelectric effect over the potassium surface. Over the potassium, if you have a potassium, you have a photoelectric effect. And if you want to have a photoelectric effect with the help of red light, then you won't be able to have it. Now you take the example of yellow light, whose frequency range is 5.1 to 5.2 to 10 power 14. This frequency range is higher than the threshold frequency of potassium. Potassium's threshold frequency is 5 into 10 power 14, whereas it is 5.1 to 5.2. So it is higher than this, and that is why even the weak brightness, that means brightness has been decreased, has been at a lower part. Even the very weak brightness of yellow light will cause to eject the electron from potassium surface. Even the least brightness, even the very, very less bright yellow light can cause ejection of electron from the potassium surface. That means very weak brightness of yellow light will cause photoelectric effect, whereas even the very strong brightness of red light does not cause photoelectric effects. So you can see here, so what is for the ejection of electron, which is important? Brightness or frequency? No brightness, no intensity. What is important? That is frequency. Frequency matters here for the ejection of electron. For number of electron, brightness or intensity matters. But to eject the electron, what matters? That is the frequency which matters, because frequency, at least this or more than this, is required to eject the electron from potassium surface. So to have a photoelectric effect, you should have a minimum frequency, threshold frequency for a specific metal, and for a number of electron, for more current, you need brightness. So if you maintain both brightness as well as frequency, then you will have good quality of current. Okay? Now, on this basis, what we can say? On this basis, what we can say? That Maxwell theory got failed here. Because what observation we have got? It is contrary to the Maxwell. According to Maxwell, if the intensity is increased, photoelectric effect should have increased. What is photoelectric effect? Ejection of electron. But here we have observed practically that there is no rise in photoelectric effect with the increase in intensity, but there is rise in photoelectric effect with the rise in frequency. So that means Maxwell's theory has been contradicted by this experimental verification. So on this verification, we have got a new theorem that we will study further. So the number of electrons ejected and kinetic energy associated with them should depend upon its intensity of light. दोनों डिपेंड करना चाहिए किस पर? इंटेंसिटी पर. काइनेटिक एनर्जी को भी डिपेंड करना चाहिए और इजेक्शन को भी डिपेंड, और उसके नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन को भी डिपेंड करना चाहिए इंटेंसिटी ऑफ लाइट पर. लेकिन क्या ऑब्जर्व किया है कि नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन तो डिपेंड करता है इंटेंसिटी के ऊपर, लेकिन काइनेटिक एनर्जी ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन तो इंटेंसिटी के ऊपर डिपेंड नहीं करता है. तो इस तरह से मैक्सवेल वेव थ्योरी जो है, ब्लैक बॉडी रेडिएशन और फोटो इलेक्ट्रिक इफेक्ट दोनों को एक्सप्लेन करने में फेल हो गया. ठीक है, तो इसीलिए अब जो है आगे हम लोग पढ़ेंगे प्लैंक्स थ्योरी, व्हिच इज नोन एज क्वांटम थ्योरी, व्हिच विल एक्सप्लेन द ब्लैक बॉडी रेडिएशन एज वेल एज दिस फोटो इलेक्ट्रिक इफेक्ट. इन द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर वी विल स्टडी अबाउट दैट. Thank you.